Good morning, Central Cabarrus. Today is Friday, October 20th, 2023. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Attention, all brave souls and thrill seekers. Get ready to face your darkest fears. We dare you to step into the spine-chilling abyss on October 28th, starting at 7 p.m. as we unveil the Hall of Horror. But beware, this is not for the faint of heart. Prepare yourselves where every creak, every whisper, and every step, an unspeakable horror awaits you around every corner. Do you have what it takes to walk the Hall of Horror? Or will you become another chilling tale whispered in the darkness? Gather your courage and join us, if you dare. But remember, you may never leave the Hall of Horror the same way you entered. See you in the halls.
Hi, my name is Nirvana.
And I'm Laura.
And we want to talk about how important it is to have a positive mindset and how detrimental those itty-bitty pessimistic thoughts can be.
So, as we all know, those itty-bitty pessimistic thoughts, they have quite the impact on everything. It affects our day-to-day lives through our actions, how we perceive ourselves, and just in general.
Yes, and listen, we know how hard it is to remain positive, like, consistently. I mean, and I say sometimes, okay, not all the times, but it is important to always have a positive outlook.
And speaking of positive, having a positive outlook, we have a few methods that can help you practice having a positive mindset. So, here's one. Before you go to bed, write something down on a sticky note, and put it up on your mirror. That way, when you wake up and you look in the mirror, you have something positive.
Another thing you can do is listen to music that's positive, you know? Just listen to something that makes you feel good, whether any genre of music you listen to, just make sure it just makes you feel good on the inside.
And the last one we will be talking about today is journaling, because writing down your feelings, I mean, could seem useless, but it actually does help a lot. So
hopefully you enjoy this video, and you know, at the end of the day, just be freaking positive, because okay, we hope you enjoyed this video.
Continuing our Viking Media Center Media Blitz, we have a change in how we all do things in the library. Mr. Smith is thrilled that so many students are using the space to work, socialize, collaborate, share ideas, and have a place at school outside of the classroom just to be. This huge increase in usage, though, means that everyone who comes into the Viking Media Center needs to work harder to take care of the space, keeping it clean and tidy out of respect for each other. Here are some pictures of breakfast trash and food left behind and smushed on the floor recently. Here are some other things left on the floor. This is unacceptable. Mr. Smith hoped that maybe this was left behind by some students from some other high school who snuck in here, but he just can't see how that can be true. You deserve to have a clean library. To help everyone give and receive that kind of respect, Mr. Smith has placed a vacuum cleaner, broom, dustpan, and other cleaning supplies around the space. When you eat a meal or snack in the library, it is your job to wipe down the table and to clean up the floor area under you. It is your job to place all the trash and remaining food in a trash can, even if it's fallen to the floor. It is a sign that you respect yourself and others. It's what we do here. Your Viking Media Center is beginning our completely optional winter book clubs. These are a great chance for students to enjoy socializing and talking about a good book together outside of class with no strings attached, like no grades nor assignments to complete, just for fun. Right now, we're offering two book club options. The first will meet before school weekly and is hosted by Miss Walker, the business teacher in her room, and will be a chance to read or reread and enjoy the world of the Hunger Games. The second will meet during Be Lunch weekly in the Media Center with Mr. Smith, the librarian, and will be a chance to read and discuss the book, The Hate U Give. Spaces are limited, and copies of the book will be provided to those who sign up. Because these are extracurricular book clubs, the books themselves explore edgy subjects and have controversial language and themes. parent/guardian permission will be required to participate. Stop by and sign up in the VMC if you're interested. Viking faculty and staff, if you are interested in starting a winter book club outside of class like this, let Mr. Smith know. Friday will be our next calm and quiet library day in your Viking Media Center. The library is reserved all day Friday for use only by students wanting to read, study, or participate in silent activities, except for the previously scheduled Interact Club meeting during Reconnect. It's a chance to escape the drama and noise and just enjoy a calm and quiet space just for you. Talking and other noise-making activities will not be allowed. Whispering will be tolerated. Shushing will be encouraged. Calm will be provided. All are welcome to the Calm and Quiet Library Day on Friday. National Technical Honor Society will have their first meeting on the 23rd of October during First Period Reconnect in the Media Center. Important information will be shared during this meeting. If you have any questions, direct them to Ms. Breeden in room 173 or Dr. Kogo Masila in room 171. Come on out and see the fall play for Central Cabarrus High School, The Servant of Two Masters, happening this weekend, Thursday through Saturday at 7 p.m. and on Sunday at 2 p.m. Hope to see you there. Due to an overwhelming interest in Interact Club, we will be moving our meetings from room 213 to the Viking Media Center. Our next meeting will be held this Friday, October 20th, during Reconnect in the VMC. Please turn in your membership forms to Ms. Mao on or before Tuesday, October 19th. If you need to turn in your form or pick one up, swing by room 213. Thank you, and we'll see you on Friday. In honor of Breast Cancer Awareness Month and the Pink Out football game this Friday, HOSA is selling pink accessories during all four lunches on Thursday and Friday, October 19th and 20th. Prices will range from $1 to $2, and only cash will be accepted. Help us fill the stadium on senior night as our Viking men's soccer team takes on Lake Norman Charter. We hope to see you there as you cheer on our 12 seniors. The application for Governor's School has opened. Governor's School is an excellent opportunity for 11th grade and some 10th grade students that thrive to learn and solve problems. Interested students should complete the interest form and attend the information session. See flyer for details. Reach out to Mrs. Palmer Faber if you have questions. Interested in designing custom objects? Interested in creating your own 3D models? Come check out 3D Print and Design Club, where you will learn how to design models, print models, and make models with a purpose. There is no prerequisite to join, but you must fill out the Google form via the link or QR code to get an appointment pass. Students without an appointment pass will not be permitted. The club meets every second and fourth Monday of the month. Look forward to seeing you there. Today's lunch will be pepperoni pizza, cheese pizza, large garden salad with hummus, and vanilla with strawberries parfait. The weather for today will be thunderstorms with a high of 66 and a low of 46. Chance of rain, 86%. The SAT word of the day is irascible, having or showing a tendency to be easily angered. Synonyms include irritable or quick-tempered. The irascible man. What side of the tree grows the most branches? The outside. Thank you for watching, Central, and have a great day.